greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. On behalf of Rogers Memorial and Fleurhof Congregational Church, I bid you a warm welcome and trust that you will enjoy today's service with us.
Our call to worship is taken from Psalm 5, and we read from verse 7 to 8. But I, through the abundance of your steadfast love, will enter your house. I will bow down toward your holy temple in the fear of you. Lead me, O Lord, in your righteousness because of my enemies. Make your way straight before me. Amen.
Kom ons bid. Ek slaan my oë op na die berge. Waar sal my hulp vandaan kom? My hulp kom van die Here, wat die hemel en aarde gemaak het. Ek is baie dankbaar dat U dit goed gesien het om 'n sondaar soos ek nog 'n kans te gee op hierdie aarde. Daar is so baie wat swyk aan die pandemie. Ek kan nie genoeg dankie sê vir U genade, Here. Ek is seker ons almal voel vanoggend bitter dankbaar om nog 'n dag in U teenwoordigheid te kan wees. Ons dien regtig 'n magtige God. Dit is weer eens 'n voorreg om U werk voor te sit vandag. En ons bid dat alles wat hier gedoen gaan word, U goedkeuring sal dra. Kom nou, Here, en wees teenwoordig. Gee ons krag en wysheid om altyd U wil te kan voldoen. Behoed, bewaar en beskerm ons teen die vyand wat ons wil verslind en leed aandoen. Vergewe ons ons skulde, net soos ons ook ons skuldenaars vergewe, en help om ons krompaaie gelyk te maak. Seën almal wat 'n bydra het vanoggend tot U diens, as ook hulle wat die boodskap luister, en wees altyd te God van nabyheid vir ons almal. Laat net U goedertierendheid en U guns ons volg, al die dae van ons lewe, van nou tot in ewigheid, tot ons eendag vir U ontmoet. Ons vra dit nie omdat ons dit werd is nie, maar omdat ons kinders is van die Here, en Hy 'n welbehae het oor ons. In Jesus wonderlike naam. Amen.
Thank you.
Greetings. I remember the words of a very old Jewish friend of mine who was in the retail business. He used to have two things. He said to me, please look after the family name, because that is all we have. The other thing he said, never worry about your enemy, because if anything happens to you, he will be the first one they will suspect. Worry about your friends, as no one will suspect them. As we look back on our lives, we have to admit that the ones who hurt us at times have been those whom we consider to be friends and trusted. So my message today takes a different look at Psalm 41 verse 9, but I trust this interpretation and this message will be a blessing unto you. Amen. Our first reading is taken from the book of Psalms. We read Psalm 41 verse 9. Even my close friend, someone I trusted, one who shared my bread, has turned against me. Our New Testament reading, which is the fulfillment of the prophecy, is taken from John 13, verse 18. It reads as follows. I am not referring to all of you. I know those I have chosen. But this is to fulfill this passage of Scripture. He who shared my bread has turned against me. This is the word of the Lord. Amen. Our enemies, we expect to treat us badly and stab us in the chest. But the knife in the back from a friend or Christian brother or sister must have caused our worst pains and scars. While it has been said to keep your friends close and your enemies closer, because you can trust your friends and need to keep your eye on your enemy, there are times when it'd be wise to evaluate your friends on a regular basis. As those who have come into a large inheritance or have won the lottery find out, friends are easy to come by when you have something people want. If you are famous, many will want to be your friends because your fame and fortune may help advance their careers. Sometimes even your friends at church are more about networking than about friendship. When a better contact arrives, you are tossed to the side, and if the new friend is your competition, the old friend may not have a problem sharing things he heard from you, about you, and about your business. We begin with a question. Who would you call your best friend? For some of us, it is our spouse. For others of us, a sibling is our best friend. For others, a childhood friend whom we still communicate with today holds the title of being our best friend. Best friends are very important. Best friends are our confidants. They are our counselors. They are our PR persons. They back us up when no others are against us. No problem is ever as dark when you have a friend to face it with you, especially when that person is a best friend. When one thinks of friends in the Bible, some natural friends come to mind. Joshua and Caleb, Jesus and the disciples, Paul and Barnabas, Paul and Silas. Biblical friendship is willing to be sacrificial in nature. We live in a give-and-take society. We give some, we take, and that is the way our relationships are based. Society, in fact, frowns on one who goes to one extreme or the other. If you are always taking, you are selfish. And always giving people are assumed to be taking advantage of you. That is how the world views things. But that is not the sacrificial nature of our biblical friendships. A group of fourth graders were interviewed, and 198 people were asked what is most important in a friendship. They interviewed their families and friends. They also asked people on the internet to join in the project. The students heard from a variety of places, near and far, and this is what the students found. Friends can trust each other. 24 responses. Friends help each other. 23 responses. Friends do things together. 18 responses. Friends are loyal to each other. 14 responses. Friends are honest with each other. 13 responses. A friend is someone that you can talk to and who listens to you. 12 responses. Friends share with each other. 8 responses. A friend is there in good times and in the bad times. 5 responses. Friends never judge you. They accept you for who you are. 5 responses. Friends have fun together. 4 responses. Interestingly enough, of the 98 responses, 99 of the responses dealt exclusively with time. How well are we doing in this area? Biblical friendship is maintained regularly. One of the saddest commentaries of our society is how we move through life disposing of relationships. Long-time friends sometimes split because of conflict. In 3 episodes of Jonathan and David's life, something took place every time. They recommitted to one another. They made sure they said to one another, I'm behind you, I'm with you, and we are in this together. As Proverbs 27, verse 17 says, as iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. We need each other. We need accountability to help us grow in the Lord. Biblical friendship has eternal benefits. It's now decision time. What sort of friendship do you choose? Or what sort of friendship do you have? A friendship based on love? A friend willing to sacrifice? Are you that friend? Are you a friend that works at maintaining a relationship? Are you a friend who brings out the best in others? Or do you have a friend that brings out the best in you? Are you a friend who sees the eternal value in your friendship? Are you that type of friend? It is now time to decide what kind of friend you are and what kind of friend you would want to be and what kind of friends you would want to have. Proverbs 18:24 says, a man of many companions may come to ruin, but there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. Do you know him? Thus, we must reach out and seek love, be it friendship, spousal, or familial, because it is part of our divine design. Yet we must go into it with eyes open, knowing that we are part of a broken race, where we may be hurt by the ones we love, and sadly, even cause hurt to those we love. We must seek to be kept in the love of God, and allow His love to navigate our lives through the mines of life, as well as avoiding the torpedoes of the world, the flesh, and the devil. So the question, my friends, is, do you know your friend? Your first friend should be Jesus. Your best friend should be your Bible. And as for the rest, you should choose them wisely. Amen.
Sometimes in our lives, we are. We all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if I have things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs that you won't let show. So just call on me, brother,
when you need a hand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
I just might have a problem that you'll understand.
We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me when you're not strong.
When you're not strong.
And I'll be your friend.
I'll be your friend.
I'll have you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Just call
on me, brother.
Heavenly Father, we pray that our pledges in sharing your ministry between churches will continue to grow as a congregation in Christ's work. We pray that we will recognize our sharing as an opportunity to express our thankfulness for the abundant blessings with which you shower us. We pray that we may show and share our gratitude with all in the ministry within our churches. We pray for the homeless, the hungry, the needy, and for all we have lost loved ones during the course of this year. As we face the ongoing pandemic, which is engulfing the universe, we appeal to you for the health and well-being of members, non-members, believers and unbelievers. As we appeal in prayer for your will to be done, let us not forget the prayer which your Son, Jesus Christ, has taught his disciples to pray and which was handed down from generation to generation, and will always be known as the Lord's Prayer in all languages and cultures throughout the universe. Let us then pray in unison. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Beloved, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and always. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Amen.